AEW Dynamite took place last night, and this was Chris Jericho's 30th anniversary. That's what the show is built around. And I apologize for the slight review, but we're going to get through this quick. He had Brian Cage defeat Will Hobbs. Not much here. Brian Cage with the win. After the match, Starks joined Cage in the ring, and Taz cut a promo on Hobbs. Then you had Darby Allin entered, and they ended up having a fight. And next, you went backstage, you had a whole bunch of wrestlers sending video tributes for Chris Jericho's anniversary, including non-wrestlers. You had Slash from Guns N' Roses. You had Dennis Miller. You had Hiroshi Tanahashi, Bully Ray, and Ted Irvine. So a lot of non-wrestlers sending video tributes for Jericho. Lance Archer sent in a video promo. The Auto Quali was awful, though. Archer said he and Moxley tore it down in New Japan, and he said he's learned a lot, and he promised to beat Mox for the belt next week. He had FTR defeat TH2. This was very boring. I was not into it too much. I thought this was okay. FTR wins the match. Young Bucks super kicked the camera operator backstage after a match. Best friends entered wearing weenie t-shirts, and they sent FTR packing, so this was not that good. MJF sent in a video tribute to Jericho, which was all right. He had Shaquille O'Neal there. He did one. He had Gene Simmons from Kiss. That was crazy. And he also had Don Callis. And I think he's in TNA. Lars Ulrich from Metallica. Holy crap. It's crazy the amount of stars they got doing one. He had DDP there. That was cool. Then he had a TNT Championship next. Cody defeated Brody Lee to win the title. That was a hell of a matchup here. He gets his revenge. Cody defeats Brody. This was a huge win for him. He gets his revenge after he was nearly viciously slaughtered by Brody Lee a month ago. Cody wins the match, and he is able to defeat Brody Lee. He cuts a great promo after a match. He said people thought that because he changed his hair, he should change his attitude and turn on the fans. Instead, he's sticking with the fans. He's sticking with the people. It's not pandering. It's his life work. And he said these people have been with him since he was a teenager. And he cuts a very good promo, and he regains his title, which was a really good segment here. He had Orange Cassidy come to the stage. Cody gives him a thumbs up, and it's Orange Cassidy and Cody next week. He had Wardlow, Colt Cabana, and Hangman Page are added to the world title tournaments. You had Alex Marvez interview Kenny Omega. Then you had, he said he'll win the tournament. Big Swole defeats Serena Deeb. This wasn't really much of a match. Serena Deeb, I don't know. I mean, she's there. I thought they'd use her more as a trainer. Well, she was a trainer in WWE. It was too bad they fired her during COVID, but it's unfortunate. Big Swole gets the victory. I don't know how much they'll push Big Swole. She did beat Britt Baker, though. She won that feud. Moxley cut the tape promo from a bar. This was all right. Not that much of a fan of this one. I thought it kind of sucked. You had Kip Sabian and Miro in action announced for next week. Cesar Pentico wins a match. He and Luther enter for a match. And you get more celebrity messages. You get Lance Storm, who's a wrestler, of course. You saw him there. After Lance Storm, you had Kevin Smith. Eli Roth, the horror movie director. Gabriel Iglesias, that's cool. Chavo Guerrero Jr., Steel Panther, Ultimo Dragon, and Paul Stanley. It's crazy. I know Jericho has a lot of friends. You shouldn't be surprised, but so we got so many names here. Some main events, Jericho and Hager against Luther Serpento. Jericho gets the one here. Jericho was like a complete babyface here. He wins the match. Him and Hager win. Everyone knew they'd win. After the match, he started to cut a promo, which was cool. But he's interrupted. MJF enters with Wardlow, and they have a surprise for him. And MJF revealed Clownicle the Clown and framed MJF posters as gifts. Jericho hit the clown with the Judas effect and broke the poster over his head. Jericho told MJF he hated clowns and never interrupted him again. And then both sold this as if something's going to happen next. Instead, they laugh it off, and then the heel locker room entered to toast Jericho in the ring as the show basically credits rolled. Basically similar to the end of Saturday Night Live, if you will. So, they basically had everyone in the credits listed as Chris Jericho. And that was it. That was the show. I enjoyed it. I thought this was a fun show, and this was definitely the Chris Jericho 30 year anniversary show, and it worked.